Good morning from Kulmbach, Germany. It's 1st of July 2018 and we have a perfect cloudless sky. Apparently there's a high pressure system over UK and North Sea driving the winds around here, and we have easterly wind blowing across the valley. This makes for a very interesting flying. Because under some height we have very turbulent sky, air, lottery about whether you will hit the thermal or end up on the ground in like 20 seconds. But after you go over that layer, air becomes quite smooth with quite strong thermals, so it's good to start high. I think the first round of this morning is getting ready to start. I'm in the sixth round, so I can wait a bit more. So as you can see, downwind from the flying field, there are a few trees and a few bushes. And yesterday we've seen lots of people walking down there to retrieve their planes, including me. Luckily with no damage. A look at the score sheet is also amazing, because there are actually very few people with any points for landing. So the wind is making quite a difference in ranking here. We are now waiting for the flyoffs to start. And although we had less wind today than yesterday, right now it's picking up again. So I'm way downwind of the start line, because I expect most action to happen around here. These are the top 10 pilots. And actually, to reach the flyoffs, just 86% of the total score was enough. Myself, I managed something like 65% with 3-0 flights, but I'm happy that my last flight was actually full 1000. Okay, about 20 seconds to start. And there's a strong gust, at least where I'm standing. Looking at the flags at the camp, it's also pretty sharp there. Okay, let's see. Low and downwind, as expected. So the game is here is to get downwind into a good position where you can observe what's happening with your model, and then hope that you have enough height to actually come back to the point. too good for this guy. One down. Looks like there's at least one more that will meet the same fate soon. Or maybe even two. Second plane down. And there was just shadow just overflown. So someone is above me, above the tree that I'm standing under. Doesn't feel too comfortable. Okay, that guy was more lucky. He got the gust that he was waiting for and is now trying to join the rest that are already high enough and in a safe attitude. That's now about a minute and a half to go. People are still looking up and for sure planes are still high enough. With this kind of wind you need to carry lots of speed on the landing, at least ground speed, so you can time your landing and with the airspeed to control your plane. One minute. There is now lots of screaming noises of people going down fast. And getting ready for final approach. That was the first flight, successful. We are waiting for one more. Only two fly-offs at this competition. Looks like they're ready to start again. Low and downwind. So now the wind has shifted direction a bit and I expect more action on my left side. There's also a bird, which is always an attractive target, and I guess they will just follow the bird. Looks a bit crowded now. But the organizer said there's no refly for a mid-air collision in fly-off. So just to get the guys ready. I hope this is enough for them to avoid any collisions. Looks like now they're gaining more distance than altitude. Let's see how this turns out. So at least one is now in a bit of a trouble. This is what I was talking about in the morning. Once you are under some height, there's nothing much you can do. Just land. Okay, now all the other planes moved downwind. I have to change my spot again. They're all at safe heights now. I just need to come back and get a good landing. Although the wind has picked up quite a lot, which I guess means good lift and good air up there. So I guess I'll just move back to the landing points. Four and a half minutes to go. And as you can see, just about everyone is looking up. Doesn't really make sense to try to record the planes. There will just be a couple of pixels on a blue background. You can imagine how that looks like. That was 1 minute to go. Air is again full of screaming planes descending from great heights. My guess would be they needed to lose something like 500 meters in 1 minute or so. Seconds. This is the density of planes to get on the final approach. And that's it. Second flight, also okay. Some people very happy, as I can see. Okay, very nice. Now let's wait and see who are the winners of this magic of observing the invisible.
Platz. So, mein Interviewpartner.
Uschi.
David Schütz.
Alles Gute. Und weiterhin. So, und jetzt haben wir natürlich eine Vergessene, die Hansa Anne. Sind die noch da? Oder sind die auch schon weg?
Bravo!
Zu mir. Das war ganz Furchtbares passiert. Die Druckerpatrone hat ihren Geist aufgegeben bei deiner Urkunde. Ja, aber ich habe es natürlich hier, schau mal, vom Gunnar sofort ein Trostpflaster gefunden. Ich glaube, das wird der Fichte über die Urkunde hinweghelfen. Ist okay? Ich schaue da hier eine nach. So, und jetzt haben wir noch ein paar Erwachsene hier. In der Zwischenzeit können wir natürlich hier was anderes auch noch erzählen. Es gibt hier einen in der Nähe wohnenden Modellbauhändler, der uns sehr wohlgesonnen ist und uns immer wieder mag. Das sollte ich auch immer sagen. Aber ihr kennt alle den Herrn Höhlein. Der Herr Höhlein hat wieder mal so eine kleine Insight hier mitgebracht. Zum Verlosen. Das heißt also, ihr dürft euch nachher ein Los hier nehmen und dann schauen wir mal, wie ihr die Inside kriegt. Ja, also lauft nachher hinweg, es kriegt jeder Teilnehmer ein Los. Und jetzt ist natürlich das ganz schlimm, dass der Michael Kress den alten Hammen gezeigt hat und dran geht.
Einen neuen Platz haben wir auch, René Petersmann. Benedikt
Feig. Oh. Ja, der Bebe.
Ich halte. Ich gehe noch mal.
Okay. Schönen Dank. Ist das? Schön, Dank. Ja. Das
ist ein Sieger und alle, die wir mitnehmen.